Thank you.
I think the Director General was making the comment that it's good they didn't ask me to dance. Your Excellency, the representative of the Honorable Minister of Finance, Dr. Claire Melamed, Executive Director for a Global Partnership for Sustainable Development Data, our UNICEF resident representative, the Director General of the NDPC, heads of various UN organizations, civil society, our development partners, acting government statistician, local and international panelists, distinguished invited guests, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor and a privilege to be asked to give an address on this very, very important occasion. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Ghana Statistical Service, which is working in collaboration with the SDG Implementation Committee and the Global Partnership for Sustainable Development Data, in putting this important conference together. The post-2015 SDG agenda provides an unprecedented context for a collective global push to address development challenges. Fundamentally, underpinning this context is a transformative element that combines sustainability, inclusiveness, and financing for the first time. The SDGs embrace a broad vision and framework that is anchored on an ambitious agenda. We have 17 SDGs with large financial footprints. In this regard, ladies and gentlemen, the adoption of the SDGs at the time of this data revolution provides us with unparalleled opportunities to track the implementation of these ambitious goals at every level of our society. Country-level commitments to the SDGs will not be feasible without fast-tracking the data revolution to provide the right information at the right time that is universally accessible to all. Ghana's attainment of SDG goals will critically be underpinned by a robust data regime that is collectively supported by all partners, including the private sector, academia, NGOs, bilateral and multilateral institutions in a harmonized manner. Ladies and gentlemen, at this critical juncture, when the amount of data that is churned out on a daily basis is progressively increasing, with constantly evolving technologies for data collection, analysis, and communication, it becomes our shared responsibility to galvanize towards harnessing this revolution for the betterment of our citizens. Whether you are a data producer or a data user, an innovator or policymaker, each of you in this room today has a stake in the data revolution and have therefore been invited to contribute your unique skills and knowledge to this forum. Ladies and gentlemen, as the link between data and development is often misrepresented or poorly understood, I'd like to reiterate the important synergies between the two. Broadly speaking, data is fundamental in showcasing our past successes, vis-a-vis development as the status quo, as well as the status quo, on the basis of which we can predict much-needed future developments. Unfortunately, however, both data production and data use have thus far been limited, not reaching their full potential in Ghana and many other countries. Unfortunately for statisticians and those who work in the collection of data, most governments do not really prioritize data collection. The political economy of that is very simple. The resources invested in data collection may not be very obvious to the average voter. So you may not see a focus on it. But governments forget that without the data, you will get your policies wrong. The data is what tells you where you are and helps you get to where you want to get to, and then you will get the votes when you get there. And so it is really something that, you know, governments have to really be reminded of, that investment in data and data collection is really, really key to development. I just don't see how you can be successful in a development agenda when you have poor data, because your decisions have to be anchored on data. And if the data is poor, you are going to make poor decisions. And this is where I think we have to keep reminding ourselves about the importance of actually providing the resources for data, because of the synergy between data production and development. Ladies and gentlemen, the SDGs mark a watershed moment in the history of statistics, propelling and bringing statistics to the very core of development. Now more than ever, statistics has moved from being a simple tool for progress monitoring and evaluation to becoming a key driver of development programs that allows for more accurate targeting of interventions, development of new products and services, and better accountability among decision makers. With increasing demand for more and better quality data, the SDGs require a step change in the types, methods, and actors involved in data production and use. Ladies and gentlemen, to sufficiently respond to the call to leave no one behind on which Agenda 2030 is premised, data will have to become more disaggregated than ever before. Whereas in the past, we have been satisfied with national or regional averages, we now seek information at district levels to adequately reflect the different realities and diversity of our beloved countries. Similarly, we must produce more and better information on the lived realities of women and men, boys and girls, to root out gender inequalities and begin to address structural discrimination that undermine women and men's progress. In Ghana, information on other marginalized groups should be systematically produced and used towards their advancement. In the context of leaving no one behind and promoting inclusive growth in Ghana, for example, the most recently passed budget specifically had programs that target poor and vulnerable groups in the society. You have a program which is Infrastructure for Poverty Eradication and Development, which basically says, well, the history has been a history of infrastructure expenditure, but very little targeting of that infrastructure expenditure to rural communities and deprived communities. And so we are going to take the existing capital expenditure envelope and take a portion of it and allocated directly to rural and deprived communities. And that is the policy where we've had the equivalent of $1 million every constituency for those particular communities. And you will need, and in addition to that, we've had the inner city development and Zongo Development Fund, you know, where we have targeted development in these particular communities. But you will need data ultimately to see what the impact of this targeting is from the baseline to what happens subsequently. And this is something that needs to be done, because you just can't say you have invested in these communities and not know what the impact of that investment has been, so that you can adjust if you need to adjust and enhance if you need to enhance. Alongside the challenge of desegregation is that of producing data on thematic areas that have hitherto been areas of focus for the official statistics community. Ladies and gentlemen, the first theme of this forum, which is addressing data gaps, will outline the challenges in more detail, while also exploring the quick wins, exciting innovations, and areas in need of long-term commitment and investments to ensure that Ghana will fulfill its global reporting requirements, as well as generate relevant data to improve Ghanaian lives. Acknowledging the censuses and surveys, that censuses and surveys will continue to be the cornerstone of any solid data system. This theme will in particular emphasize the importance of building the administrative data system and ensuring harmonization and interoperability between the databases. Ghana has recently made strides in this area, for example, through the implementation of a new civil registration and vital statistics registry and an ambitious national identification program, which together with powerful tools to capture and record the most significant events in Ghanaian lives while enabling better public services simultaneously. We in Ghana have decided that one of the major problems in terms of development has been the largely informal nature of our economy. It's so informal that even gathering data is very difficult. And to modernize this economy, you need to formalize the economy. And in that context, we have identified three main pillars of formalization. And those three main pillars of formalization also help inclusion in the development process of people who have largely been outside. And these three pillars are making sure that everybody is identified. So this year, we are issuing national ID cards for the population. The second pillar is to make sure that where everybody lives is also identified. So we are implementing a digital addressing system this year so that we can identify every property or location. And it will also therefore help in the delivery of services targeted at particular places. So it's a major step forward for Ghana that we are able to use available technology, digital mapping, to leapfrog and be able to do an addressing system which will be far advanced than most of the advanced countries today. But it's just coming late to the game allows you to do that type of leapfrogging. So we'll do the national ID system, we'll do the national digital addressing system, and then we will enhance mobile interoperability with the banks to make sure that most of the people outside the banking system are included. These three pillars are very key to formalization. And once formalization takes hold, you can uniquely identify people, you can get where they live, and with the resources that we want to use to attack poverty, you can deliver them with delivery channels that are accessible across the country. Then you will be able to collect very valuable data with all of this particular interaction. So we are making some major changes as far as the formalization of our society is concerned. And it is all consistent with the SDG goals. This brings me to the second theme of this conference, which is encouraging data use. As I mentioned earlier, data is not only envisaged as a way to measure progress, but rather to be used to drive progress itself. This can only be achieved when data producers and users engage in an iterative feedback loop, ensuring that data produced matches user needs. This refers not only to production of data, but all other steps in that data cycle, ensuring that data is communicated and disseminated in a way that various users can easily comprehend and in a format that allows the data to be used and reused without restriction. That is open data. Once data producers have fulfilled these requirements, the onus will surely fall on decision makers in all sectors to use this data. Indeed, the tasks and opportunities that lay ahead are exciting and daunting in equal measure. The third theme of the forum, which is strengthening the data ecosystem, acknowledges the traditional national statistical system comprising the Ghana Statistical Service, in the case of Ghana, and selected ministries, departments, and agencies. They alone will not be able to produce all the data required for the SDGs and for other national and regional agendas to which Ghana and other countries are committed. Indeed, apart from data production, stakeholders represented here today will play key roles in encouraging use of data, in creating policy legislation and regulation that facilitate data sharing, providing expertise in the use of new technologies and types of data, and in supporting through resource allocation or in other ways the entire data ecosystem. Over the next 2 days, I would encourage you all to form new data communities either around the particular thematic areas or cross-cutting issues so that you can continue to learn from one another and work together in the coming years. As the forum's title suggests, we are here to begin conversations around a national data roadmap for sustainable development. It is important to stress that this roadmap is not a document that we will produce at the end of this week or month or year. Rather, it will be a living process that will continue to evolve until 2030 and will require ongoing continued efforts from all of us. I'm particularly gratified to have with us representatives from other countries who can share experiences of their roadmap processes, alongside our international counterparts who have come to share their expertise with us. We will use the next 2 days to achieve the following. We will identify opportunities to align national development priorities and the SDGs. We'll identify key data and technology gaps and potential new methods, sources of data and technologies to address them. Understand the data ecosystem in Ghana and foster the creation of sector-specific and cross-cutting data communities. We'll identify key issues on funding, resources, and capacity. Ladies and gentlemen, we all appreciate the potential of data to drive the development of our countries. I look forward to the outcome of this meeting, which will discuss over the coming 2 days the most promising ways to unlock this potential to ensure that Ghana achieves its development priorities, making the vision of the world we want a reality. I wish you fruitful deliberations, and thank you very much for your attention.